Joining me now to talk about the boisterous New York campaign of the past 2 weeks is Bob Hardt, the political director for New York One, New York City's 24/7 news channel. Bob, you covered Hillary Clinton when she was running for Senate in 2000, and because she wasn't from New York, she sort of presented herself as, I'm on a job interview and you should hire me.
Right.
Is there any shades of that in this campaign?
Definitely. I'm having some deja vu all over again. It's really interesting to see her crisscrossing the state, spending a lot of time in the city, but also going upstate, sort of reintroducing herself to voters, reminding them that she was their senator for 8 years, and also encountering Bernie Sanders voters who don't remember her when she was a senator because she left after 2008. So there's a little bit of that reintroduction and an introduction to these younger voters who she's desperately trying to steal away from the Bernie Sanders camp.
Bernie Sanders has obviously had some enthusiastic supporters in New York. We've seen the big rallies in Washington Square Park and in the Bronx. But part of his big message is to go after the financial sector. But here in New York City, 1 in 10 jobs is attached somehow to the financial sector, right? It goes into all livelihoods.
Exactly. It'd be like going to Texas and talking about the oil industry as a net bad. Mm-hmm. The thing that helps him is that a lot of Democratic voters, this isn't a general election, so some Democratic voters agree with him. So while the message might be a little dissonant to some New Yorkers who do have jobs on Wall Street, and there are Democrats who do work on Wall Street, mm-hmm. I don't think it hurts them as much as if this were a general election. I think it'll be a big problem then.
Donald Trump is a true
right.
New Yorker here,
right.
Name on buildings all over New York City, but downstate New York and upstate New York are vastly different, not in lockstep. So how is Donald Trump playing upstate?
Well, that's the thing. There's really like three states. There's suburban New York City, there's New York City, and there's upstate. Upstate, he's playing very, very well. I think there's some of that kind of what we've seen in Michigan is some industrial places upstate that no longer have the jobs. Mm-hmm. So he's going there and saying, hey, I'm going to bring industry back. I'm going to go after those companies that have taken those jobs abroad. In the city, it's interesting. He hasn't really done that many rallies until this weekend. He's out on Staten Island, but we really haven't seen him here. On Long Island, he was out there, and he was doing very, very well. His numbers, his poll numbers are doing great statewide in the Republican race, but he's really, really resonating out there.
You've written about how this is, for both parties, an incredibly competitive New York primary like we haven't seen in a really long time, and it's led to some sort of weird campaigning.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about some of the things you've seen that you've made you scratch your head.
Well, it's just funny. John Kasich is basically eating his way across New York. Like, he's on Arthur Avenue in the Bronx. I've never seen him eat more. It's very, very funny to see Ted Cruz at a matzah factory in Brooklyn trying to court the conservative Jewish vote. You see these kind of things in New York during a gubernatorial race, a Senate race, a mayoral race. We haven't had presidential candidates come here except to fundraise since 1992. When Bill Clinton was really trying to put away Jerry Brown, mm-hmm. Trying to deal with Paul Tsongas. 1988, you had Michael Dukakis here running hard. But that's a long, long time ago. So for the first time in April, as it's a beautiful spring day, we're also seeing the candidates in a way that we really haven't seen them in more than 20 years.
Bob Hardt from New York One, thanks for sharing your reporting.
It's great to be here.